So, okay, welcome to everyone, welcome to everybody. This webinar will be in English, a moment, in my very bad English. The webinar is starting in this moment. FFT Analyzer, born for light tuning, like smart system, satellite, etc., 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 and this is my personal opinion, are not probably the best tool, no, for STI measurement purposes. But, end of the webinar. I will explain now what I mean. Okay. Can you listen me? All okay? So, I will illustrate measurement computation methods of STI with the smart beta version 8.5, exactly, just released. I have tried to outline operational indication with two examples, but I believe that these are still at the limit of the standard, at the boundary of the standard. So I invite you to listen to my words and to this webinar just in general. So just a sort of reminder of the previous webinar on STI. I recommend that you will follow the official support of Rational Acoustics for this topic. I will use the beta version 8.5 that can be downloaded from the download area of your main Rational Acoustics account. Refer to my previous webinar on STI for the theoretical contents. So, SMART, like many other software FFT analyzer, compute STI with the indirect method based on the impulse response. According to the standard, remember my previous webinar, we can perform two types of measurement for STI. The direct method, the so-called full STI, or one of its shortened versions such as STIPA or STITEL, and the indirect method based on the impulse response computation gathering. Common FFT analyzer for light tuning are not the best tool, as I said, to do this. They can, but with some limitation. This means that if the user is not well informed and expert, it can be a problem. But I'm asking to myself, no? If you are an expert, You are probably the professional that regularly use other tools, which are specifically designed for this purpose. We saw them last time in the previous webinar, no? FFT analyzer have inherent limits in the way they obtain data and perform FFT analysis. Just some example. The FFT works by predefined blocks. This means that the frequency resolution depends on the size of these blocks. You have to use RTA to record, for example, with these softwares, the background noise and the signal plus noise, okay? That are the two of the four ingredients that I explained you in the previous webinar. Often, data window and other processes like overlap and save are generally applied on data. I want to show you this. I share my screen. Okay, audio looks okay. I open Smart. Are you looking at my screen? If you have a question, can write in the comments here on Facebook. So I play the generator. I perform an RTA measurement. I can select a predefined series, predefined number of samples for the FFT size. Okay, in this case, the maximum block number of samples that you can use and select in the spectrum mode in Smart is a 32K point, 32K data point. In this case, frequency resolution is 1.5. This is the lowest frequency that you can compute, that you can measure, okay, 1.5. Remember that the modulation frequencies are very low in frequency, 0.2, 0.3, 1, etc. So this is a limit for the measurement that you can perform in spectrum mode. Can be not a problem if you consider that the background noise recording and the signal plus noise recording is required in octave band, but this is a limit. So I return to my presentation. Is it clear? Share this. Any question? So, these are inherent limits of the FFT analyzer. The standard requires noiseless impulse response. This means that you can perform surely the impulse response in absence of noise, okay? But the standard requires also the noiseless gathering of the impulse response. So this means with the method that ensure you an impulse response without distortion product and self-noise of measurement system. With these softwares, you cannot perform the convolution without the use of other software. And the convolution is the key that permits you to isolate in negative time the distortion product and to lower the background noise, the self noise of the measurement system, okay? Your audio device, your PC, softwares, the speakers that you use for the signal test, and often you must use a sweep to record an impulse response, okay? A noiseless room impulse response is the foundation of our work. Other limit, the impulse response obtained with this software, and with this software I mean smart system, I repeat, satellite, all these common software for light tuning, obtains the impulse response with a layer of mat that is the inverse fast Fourier transform on the data yet obtained with another layer of mat that is the fast Fourier transform applied on the data in the time domain, okay? So the analyzer perform a first layer of mat with which it obtains the informations in terms of spectrum in frequency domain. So spectrum for the input channel and information in terms of magnitude and phase for the transfer function visualization in the frequency domain, okay? So on these data in the frequency domain, an EFFT, an inverse fast Fourier transform, is performed to reconstruct the impulse response. With the previous method instead, with the method that and the software that I showed you in the previous STI webinar, the recording give you directly the data point in the time domain. On this directly, you perform the STI measurement. Okay? Is clear this difference? Consider, as always like to say, entropy of any system always increases with time, and as you start to include the room, the effectiveness of transfer function decrease. I hope is clear what I'm saying. The FFT analyzer progressively lose effectiveness as they incorporate the effect of time in space. The more late and uncorrelate phenomena you include in the analysis, the more FFT analyzer lose their effectiveness. This is why a look at the time domain with room impulse response is essential. So, this a slide from the standard, ESC standard, with the resume the causes of failure of the STI measures: frequency shifters, time domain distortions, such as electronic echoes, dropout of system, compression, wind, all the non-linearity and the time invariances of measurement system, of sound system, of room, of the environment in general. A bad frequency response of the system, for sure. The indirect method consists in a noiseless room impulse response recording. So, an impulse response measurement without the distortion product and the background noise of the measurement system. And in the separate estimation of the spectra of the signal and the spectra of the noise. It is a good idea to average the results of several positions along an area. I have chosen two hypotheses of situations that can best illustrate a methodology that reflects my way of seeing things according to the standard. So let's consider a newly built school classroom, which we want to verify the compliance of the construction with the standards, for example, and a classroom with a sound system, a sound reinforcement system installed, which we want to test for intelligibility. As a reminder, four are the ingredients we need. They are, in the previous methods, four recordings. In this case, it will be the calibration of the measurement system, the background noise measure, the signal plus noise measure, and attention, the signal plus noise minus noise signal, okay, result. We need the result. When you record the signal test for STI, you record both the signal test and the background noise. The impulse response of recording. Tools for the work. An appropriate test signal, standard compliant with the male and female human voice spectrum. Remember what I said last time. This means that the signal test must be a pink noise filtered in octave bands, in the eighth octave band. So from 1025 to 8 kilohertz, okay? But it must be also equalized for human voice, for male and female human voice. You need also a tall box, a special speaker that is similar in its characteristics to the voice, to the human voice. So with a flat frequency response over the range from 88 hertz to 11.3 kilohertz, that are the limit of the 125 hertz band and the upper limit of the 8 kilohertz octave bands. Okay, why I'm saying flat? Attention here, to be compliance with the standard in terms of frequency response, must be the system, okay? So the signal test plus the speaker. You equalize what you measure in the output of the speaker, okay? Measuring the speaker. This is a common misconception around this thing. Also, the speaker, the vocal box or tall box, like you want to talk it to say, must be calibrated to generate a sound pressure of 60 dBA a weight at 1 meter of distance in axis. It must have the directional characteristic of the human voice. For measure, you can use an omnidirectional microphone. All clear? You need some explanation? I was not clear in something due to my very bad English. You want to repeat something? Can answer on comments. Put your question here. Probably best in my page. I go in my page, so I read I read the questions. So I continue. If you are measuring only the STI of the room to verify, for example, the acoustics of the new building, put the vocal box, at the teacher position. If instead you are measuring a sound system, put always the tall box at the talker position in front and on axis to the talker's microphone. For the recording of the signal plus noise, you use the vocal box to emit the signal test. Instead, attention here, for the recording of the room impulse response, if the room is not very large, is small, a classroom, for example, okay, you can use the vocal box itself at its maximum level to play the sweep. Remember, you must to use the sweep, okay? For very large room instead, you must use a dodecahedron. What you need to measure, in fact, in this step is not the STI parameter yet, is the room, okay? So you must to stimulate the room with the best, in the best way you can. And if the room is very large, the talk box is insufficient, is inadequate to perform a sweep and to obtain a good signal to noise ratio. Horrible English. So a dodecahedron must be to use in this example. Walk around the room, performing both impulsive sound that continuous noise. And if you can use also a small subwoofer. This allow you to choose the most representative positions along the area and for each to detect echoes or other acoustic peculiarities. Only the listen, only listening the room can help you in this work. This allow you also to identify the modal resonances if the case, for example, if we are in a not very huge room, and so pressure zones and null. Choose a number of locations representative of the area, of the entire area, or according the needs, you can perform surely just one measure, for example, it depends. So first step, the first thing you must do, you need the calibration of the system. So I show you directly. Moment, I share my first screen. I go in smart. I calibrate the input of my sound card. The microphone is the channel one. Okay, I repeat the process for you. So where is my calibrator? Where is the calibrator? A moment, I don't find my calibrator. terrible. My calibrator is missed. Incredible. A moment. My calibrator. Panic. So I press on calibrate. I select my input channel. Put the calibrator on microphone. Select the calibration. Pressure lever. On. Choose your lever, for example, this. Press calibrate. Write again the pressure. The sound pressure level that Smart is listen in the camera of the calibrator. We write 94, enter, okay. We have calibrated the system. It is very important. Second step, I return to the presentation. The setup of the generator, the internal generator in Smart. You must to select pseudo random if you intend to record the impulse response with noise instead of sweep, or if you want to use the internal generator and signal of Smart for the speaker, but generally this vocal box, this tall box has yet inside them the right test tool for STI measurement. So you just on the speaker and you have inside the full STI signal test or the STIPA signal test. That, remember, is a signal, a pink noise filter, band limited, equalized, and also modulated by the modulation frequency. So in this case, we will use these setups for this option for the internal generator in SMART. Select pseudo random, select drop wire data window, select, here you can see what I said before, select speech weighted signal test. This automatically filter band limit the signal test, okay, from 125 to 8 kHz band. I want to show directly in SMART this. As you can see, moment. First screen, SMART, signal generator. When you select speech weighted, automatically the signal is filtered, okay? If I play the signal generator and I select, for example, generator, you can see here, in octave, the signal test, okay? Speech weighted and band limited. If I select just, so if I remove the option, this is the pink noise just filtered, just band limited. I show you another thing. In signal generator, I select file. And so I use now the official signal test for full STI method. Full STI, see? CEA. On. As you can hear, listen, this is the kind of signal test for STI measurement, the full STI. You can listen that is yet band limited, yet filtered, but it is also modulated in low frequency. I show you. As you can see, is very similar to the signal test with the option speech weighted in SMART, okay? But the internal signal is not modulated. This not matter because we are not performing a full STI measurement. We have performed an indirect method, and in the indirect method, you just use the pink noise band limit and equalized, and the software can will do all the math necessary to perform all the, to obtain all the 98. Matrix value of the full STI measurement for multi-transfer function values, okay? So in this method, using so smart system satellite, you can just use the internal filtered and speech weighted signal test. You can also use the official test. Okay, is clear this thing? Questions? Okay, looks all clear. Jesus de las Eras ask, when calibrating, the value that you get into in micro one in option, should you also put, no, you, calibration is a one channel measurement type of measurement. Consider calibration a measurement type, okay? Calibration process is related to the single channel, okay? You calibrate one channel at a time. In fact, you select here the audio device and also the channel that you want to calibrate. In this case, I have selected one channel, the first channel, okay? It is very important, this thing, because it is often object of confusion. Okay. Remember, you are performing an indirect method with when you use this software to measure the STI. Okay. Share the second screen. Perfect. Thanks, Jesus, for the question. Interesting. Other question? So these are in the bottom part of the image. You can see the spectra of the band limited pink noise equalized for speech, for human speech, for male and female speech. Okay, now we must to record the first ingredient, no? The background noise measurement. In the previous webinar, the method used consider this step as a recording of the background noise. Here, we substitute the recording with the measurement with the RTA. The option, I show you in Smart directly. Okay, what we have to do, select RTA, select as bending octave, okay? For the moment, don't use average, because the background noise is characterized by a continuous noise, but also by impulsive sounds, okay? So you have two options. You can average, for example, 1 second, 2 seconds, 5 seconds, or best, you can don't apply average, that is another layer of math at the end. So, don't apply average and performs many spectrum measurements along the area. Okay, as I said previously, I have yet choose my strategical positions. Okay, I will do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4 RTA measurement for every position, okay? And so I want to simulate the background noise of a classroom of a school. Let me classroom noise. Okay. This is a typical background noise in a school, for example. You can listen it. So, hi Walter. Now I measure this background noise. Okay, this is the typical background noise that disturb, that lower the speech intelligibility. Okay. A moment, I need to repeat the calibration because I have moved the the knob for error. So yes, I put my calibrator on microphone. Okay, I select the channel I want to meter. I go in configure, IO configuration, select my sound card, select the channel I want to calibrate with all the rest. I press calibrate again. Write 94, press enter, press okay again, and you are calibrated. Plus minus. So I record the background noise. I make more measurement. I say now more measurement. I'm not moving the microphone here, but in reality you move the microphone and you perform many RTA measurement in any position. Without averaging the measure, you can see all the noise, the type of noise you hear, you listen, you recognize these. So, for example, I have performed a dozen of measures, also more. Perfect. Quite a moment. Noise. Select all the measure stored. Right click of the mouse, click on average, and select this type of average, dB. You need a linear average in this case, okay? if you perform the power type of measure of average, is not the best solution, okay? Now you have the average with another overestimation of the very low frequency. It is a wrong data. It is not real. But we are interested in the octave band from 125 to 8. Now I play the vocal box, yet calibrated to have 16 dB SPL A weighted at 1 meter. That is in the teacher position. So we perform the full ST singer, for example, or the yet filtered pink noise. Okay, make sure, in fact, verify anyway. Speech weighted is selected. Lower the level of the speaker. These are 60 dB A. Okay. This is the level, typical level of the vocal box in STI measurement. Other option, in the measure, you select the best FFT size. Select also A weighted. Okay, that's okay. And now we measure the signal plus noise. The noise is not magical disappeared, okay? The noise is always present in the classroom. Where is the noise? Make more recording, more measurement, more RTA measurement. You can see the typical behavior of the frequency response of the background noise. So you have this measure done. I stop the generator. I stop the measure. Now average the measurement dB. Okay, there is another estimation here in low frequency, but keep this as good. I repeat, one measure only for the background noise only. I'm trying to look at an average behavior. This. I measure signal plus noise. Okay. Now, we are ready to perform the impulse response. We have calibrated the measurement system. We have the background noise recording measurement. We have the signal plus noise recording. We need the impulse response. I go in impulse mode. I show you again my second screen. You see the slide? Okay. A moment before to talk about the impulse response. To perform, if you remember the last webinar, in reality, you need the background noise and the signal plus noise to calculate the signal only value measured in the presence of the noise. So you have to perform a subtraction of the values recorded for the signal plus noise and the noise. So many app file of this software don't say this, but this is important. This is very important. What you must to consider is not the signal plus noise value. You obtain the signal plus noise because you measure the signal with the noise present, okay? You have so to make a subtraction from these values, band for band. Signal plus noise minus noise. I have prepared an Excel file. I will share this with you. I will link the file for download, okay? This way you can easily can perform the subtraction. It is not a simple subtraction. Eh? You are subtract with the B. Remember this. Okay, impulse response. These are the parameters you have to select to adjust. Deselect the high pass filter and the low pass filter in impulse response option. Also, set the magnitude threshold level to a low level that is comfortable above the electronic self-noise level of your reference signal input, okay? So you go in the RTI, in the RTA for the input channel you are using to measure, or as a reference, in this case is the same, and use the RTA in the no banding visualization to detect this level, this magnitude threshold to set. The magnitude threshold for impulse response measurement in the RTA, in fact, is based on a white noise spectrum. So you can use the RTI in smart with banding set to known to determine the self noise level of the input. In the main smart window in impulse response mode, set the FFT time constant to 5,000 milliseconds, 5 seconds. The FFT associated with the 5-second option will depend on the sampling rate being used. Okay. Note that the if you remember, no, the 1.6 second minimum time constant specified in the standard is inadequate to provide data points for all the lowest modulation frequencies. Okay, since the modulation frequencies are spaced 1/3 octave increments, and the first two data points in a FFT are always a full octave apart. Okay, a five second time constant provides a frequency resolution of 0.2 Hz, which give you that point very close to or exactly at 0.63, 0.8, 1.0, plus minus are the values of the our modulation frequency. What I said at the beginning, at the when I talked of the limits of the FFT analyzer. So to perform an impulse response in SMART, you have to select a right time constant, a right time span for the impulse response, at least 5 seconds. So you select these FFT sites. Are you seeing the, okay. Question? It's clear this thing. To get a best resolution, a best frequency resolution, so to obtain data point, frequency point, near to the values of the modulation frequency, you have to use at least 5 seconds of time constant for the recording, for the gathering of the impulse response. Start with no averaging. In this case, probably no average is a good option. It depends on the situation, okay? In the presence of very disturbing noise, using more average can help the a best signal to noise ratio, okay, if you are using a pseudo-random noise. Instead, I suggest to use the sweep, a logarithmic sweep. Obtained, performed the impulse response measurement, don't crop the impulse response, okay? Because this reduces the best signal to noise you have gathered. And there is one of the problem, because this type of analyzer, what I have said before, no, using a sweep for the best signal to noise ratio, probably will create in your measure distortion products. And this distortion product plus self noise of the system, of the measurement system, will be in the positive time, so will be in the of the impulse response, so will be in the time span you have used for to record impulse response. With convolution instead, you can put this distortion product in negative time, so you can cut this out of the time span that is on which you are interested, okay? This is valid for SMART, is valid for system, for cycle, for any kind of this type of software. So perform now the measurement of the impulse response with SMART. Change screen. I select 5 seconds of time constant. I select pink sweep. That is, attention, not the exponential, properly the exponential sine sweep we used with other softwares, okay? Also, this is another problem. But anyway, if you are using this software, probably you are interested in a general estimation of the STI parameter. So, silence, and we record the impulse response. For this step, you can up the level of the speaker. This is our impulse response. First, impulse response. Low level of the speaker. Now, for example, in the case that I have more noise, so you can get a best signal to noise, an optimum signal to noise ratio, okay? I up the level of the speaker. I use a dodecahedron, for example, that give me more power. We are good now, but distortion product start to appear in the measure. Okay, is clear. Try pseudo random noise. Not good. You have to use, in these cases, the sweep. But the problem with the sweep is that is a very, it has great energy, okay? So it stimulates tightly the product, the distortion product of the loudspeaker that we are using for the sweep. And as you can see, distortion products are present now in the impulse response. They are part of the measure of the time span you need. You need necessarily this time span. You can cut the impulse response now. Okay, what you do? You can do anything. Okay, the only way to repair this problem is to use the convolution. But you can do this in this software. You need to use a third-party software to do this. Okay? But I repeat, we are not, stop this noise. I'm not performing an STI according to some regulation, etc. If I'm using SMART or System or Satellite, probably I'm interested in just in a general idea around the parameter of STI, okay? This is what I want to say you. Now, I have obtained the impulse response. For example, is this, the first one. We press on the button all bands, pressing all bands. Well, English. Pressing calculate STI and select noiseless before, because here SMART give you two options. You will read this in the next manual, because STI module was totally reviewed in the last beta version. Okay, so soon will be available an upgrade of the manual for this. As you can see, you can choose between a noise present and noiseless. You are always in presence of the noise, okay? If you press select noise present, SMART compute directly the STI value. Is excellent according to him. But the right tool that I consider, that I want to show you, for me is the right option, is to select noiseless, write the level of your signal test, the voice through the vocal box, so 60. And now you can import the background noise, okay? Remember the RCA measurement saved in real-time mode, okay? You find them here. The average one was the background noise, if I remember exactly, no? Yes, this was. So SMART incorporate directly the levels are weighted in this case for the background noise, and it compute the STI 0.8. Okay, a good value. We are in my room. The microphone is near the speaker. The speaker is a loudspeaker. A two-way loudspeaker, like others, or like a common loudspeaker on table. So in this ideal situation, it perform an excellent value of STI. What I said before, if you do directly the importation, you import in this row the signal plus the just the noise, okay? You can't import the signal values are weighted, at a difference with the original method I explained in the first webinar. So this is the way to perform plus minus good measurement of STI in SMART, or similar is the process also in other software. In System is a little different. In satellite, if I remember, you don't have many possibility to do this, okay? So for among the common FFT analyzer used in light tuning, these three are, if I remember right, the only one that have the option to measure STI, okay? The other no, for now. All clear? I hope yes, because it is very difficult for me in English. There are questions? Or we can stop the webinar. How is thanks for participation. The English is good. It is understandable. Understandable, no. You can understand the what I have said. Alexander, thanks. Okay. Intelligible. Thanks, Joel. Question about the procedure, something not clear. So it is important when you measure the impulse response to remember that you are measuring the room, okay? You must use a speech weighted and filtered pink noise, because it's the process that that reconstruct the matrix value for the multi-transfer modulation transfer function from the shredder of the impulse response. Okay, it's just math, nothing that you have to do. Remember that using SMART, you recording the gathering the impulse response, you must use a time constant of at minimum, at last 5 seconds, 5,000 milliseconds. When you record the signal plus noise, you on the loudspeaker, the vocal box, and measure in many positions to average this data along the area. Remember too that to get the just signal in a value in any position, you must perform a subtraction of the of this value, signal plus noise and the background noise. Okay, no question. Thanks to all. Bye.